here you can see almost all of East Cleveland. Our beliefs are said to be formed by imaginary relationships with the real conditions of existence. Once, women would walk down East Cleveland streets freely, following and harassing men, verbally expressing their desires that only men could fulfill. Their desires were not bodily, but rather the freedom to vote. I've been thinking about freedom, a fleeting, finite thing that always escapes us. Women found freedom in parks at the turn of the century. The tamed outdoors were just an extension of domesticity outwards. The morality of womanhood was to be found in the company of romantic visions of the picturesque landscapes. Undefined paths meant to evoke classical paintings. The foreground of the ornamental, a middle ground of parkland, and a background that's wild. These paths are not the perimeter, but an aperture. A space through which the world can be seen. Harriet saw a different world, one caught in the act of becoming, speaking into darkness with little hope of response. She and her sisters engaged in a desperate struggle for freedom, leaving behind the false femininity of frills and furbelows, and created a true purpose and accomplishment. The trees here must hold such stories. They are older than the city itself. Most of them are too big to wrap your arms around, too big to be known by human scale. Ragged with time, weighed down by history. Slowly dying of diseases from invasive species brought by invasive cultures. I often wonder about the grieving this land has experienced.